Hi, I'm Barbara Rimkunis, and this is your Exeter History Minute. For 88 years, from 1867 to 1955, Exeter had separate public high schools for boys and girls. The boys went to Exeter High School, and the girls went to the Robinson Female Seminary. Female academies were a visionary idea in the field of women's education, and yet, although the faculty was overwhelmingly comprised of women, the school was only headed by women for 14 of its 88 years. When the school opened in 1867, classes were held in the old townhouse on Court Street. The new building was still under construction for the first chaotic years. The trustees hired Abby Wooster to organize and head the school. We don't have a photo of her in our collections. She was an experienced teacher from Hollis, educated at Kimball Union Academy and Framingham Normal School. Her pay was $800 a year. When the big day came in 1869 to dedicate the new school, Wooster was asked to step down. The new principal would be a man, Eben Stearns, who was paid $3,000 a year and the use of the new principal's house. To thank her, they gave her a small raise and the title of assistant teacher. She stayed a few months to help them through the transition before leaving teaching for good. I'm sure they wondered why. Stearns stayed on until 1875, when he was offered a position in Tennessee. The trustees immediately promoted Harriet Payne to head the school. She served as principal, and the Alumni Association would later list her as such. But the trustees did not grant her that title, and she wasn't given the principal's house to live in. It wouldn't have been seemly for a 30-year-old single woman, apparently. She was a graduate of Wheaton Seminary in Massachusetts. She stayed in Exeter until 1878 before returning home to Groveland, Massachusetts. Later, she became a writer using the pen name Eliza Chester. With little time to interview for the position, the trustees then hired Annie Killam. Like Payne, she was a graduate of Wheaton Seminary. She was only 27 years old when she took the job, and she served for 5 years. After that, she returned to Wheaton, where she taught Latin, English, German, mathematics, natural philosophy, and astronomy. Killam Hall on the Wheaton College campus is named in her honor. After her departure, the trustees decided to hire a man. Very specifically decided to hire a man. They wrote, the duties of the principal were too arduous to be imposed upon a lady, and that they wanted to place a gentleman at the head of the school. And they did just that, and for the remainder of the school's existence, only hired men. There was one other woman, however, who served as principal. During World War II, when Principal James Purney was called to service, Bessie Jakes, the unflappable English teacher, a Radcliffe graduate, stepped in as acting principal. Jake stepped down after Purney returned a few years later. The four women who headed the Robinson Female Seminary were not shrinking violets. Capable and well-educated, they were all up to the task in spite of the restrictions placed on them. Before wrapping this up, I'm sure you're all wondering about Exeter High School. Co-ed prior to 1867 and then again after 1955, Exeter has only once had a female principal, Susan Ratnoff, who held the position from 1996 to 1999. Oh, come on. For more Exeter history, check our website at www.exeterhistory.org.